What's up, everybody? Awesome day so far. In the world of renovating and construction, schedules are a nightmare. Not the schedules themselves, but trying to stay on schedule. Getting 8 to 10 subcontractors on the same page can be challenging. And today, virtually every job site I've been to is on schedule or ahead of schedule. So great job by our project management department, Chad and Brian, Bill, Dee. We got a couple people already hopping on here. Michelle, how are you? Robert Hunt, what's up? I want to talk about experience. I hear this term used quite a bit, and I think there's a lot of us. Sorry, I had a call coming. There's a lot of assumptions that are made about experience. People advertise all the time. They got 15 years worth of experience, 25 years worth of experience. Corey, how are you? Dawn, Mr. Khan, what's up? And while experience can certainly be a valuable asset, I think too often people don't get the most value out of experience. And I wanted to explain why that's the case, and you know, my personal experience and how that has evolved and how I've been able to see that sort of unfold. And it really starts with, you know, and I got this out of a book that I'm listening to, that let's say 10 years of experience, right? We make these assumptions that over those 10 years that a particular person or a company or a group of people, a team or whatever, over those 10 years has 10 unique experiences that they've evolved and developed over those 10 years. While we've certainly gotten older, there's mistakes that we made over those 10 years that we may be able to avoid moving forward. The real problem is that most people with 10 years of experience really only have 1 year of experience 10 times. So let that sink in for a second. What I'm saying is that someone can have 10 years of experience, but really only have 1 year of experience repeated 10 times. If you continue to do the same things over and over and over again for 10 years, you're taking the word experience, I think, completely out of context. Experience should insinuate and come along with growth. And if you're not, so here's the point. Here's experience is 50% or a large part of the equation, but it requires what I would call reflection or insight. And this comes from knowing the why over knowing how, right? Like, so if you know how to do something, right? Like, let's say, you know how to change the oil on a car, but you don't know why it's done a certain way. Why do we drain the oil completely empty before we refill it? Why do we dispose of the oil the way that we do? So you know how, but you don't know why. It's inevitable that that process or that how is going to change or should change to become more efficient or better. So it's vital that, particularly as leaders and as people, as we live our lives, that we use experience, combine it with reflection. And I think one of the biggest problems is with reflection is it requires some humility. A lot of people choose not to reflect on an experience because it somehow is an admittance of fault or an admittance of some type of wrongdoing on their part. So you have to have a certain amount of humility and be humble to be able to properly reflect and take responsibility for whatever role that you played in a scenario, whether the outcome was positive or negative or somewhere in between. So in order to have real experience, you have to take the time and the fact that you've been through something and then can combine it with insight and reflection. So that's how you get to know why, and why that is more valuable than I think than to know how. Sorry, I made some notes here. And, you know, so the real value in what I'm trying to share with you today, and what I've learned is that you need to be able to reflect on a situation, develop insight, right? A lot of people call this a debriefing or whatever. If you're talking about, something that occurred, a lot of times the military will use a debriefing, or larger corporations use a debriefing to sort of walk down a set of, something that happened, and be able to walk away with a real lesson and some real insight about what happened, and then make, any type of changes or encourage the behavior that led to a positive outcome. So if you're not taking your experience and combining it with reflection, you're basically just living 10 years the same way you did the first year 10 different times, which is not the real value in experience. The thought should be is that from the first year to the second year to the third year, that you're constantly developing and evolving throughout those 10 years. So just think about that. As you go through life and you gain experience, make sure you're not just accumulating time, but you're accumulating real insight and reflection on the way things happen and why they happen, so that you can develop as a person, develop as a leader, develop as a company, develop as a team, whatever it is that you're doing. The real value and experience is the reflection and the humility for you to be able to sort of debrief a situation and walk away with a real lesson. And that is the value and experience. I hope everybody has a great day. Sorry this is a short one, but I thought it was really good, so I wanted to share it. We'll see you guys. Take care.